In the late 1800s, the United States experienced rapid industrial growth. Many people left rural areas or their homes in Europe to find work in the new factories in America's cities. Large corporations spread across the country. New schools and universities were established to educate the growing workforce. As people became more educated, the newspaper and publishing industries boomed. But this period of growth also included corruption and inequality. Big businesses often used their growing profits and power to destroy competitors and form monopolies in the railroad, steel, coal, and oil industries. Working conditions in mines and factories were harsh and dangerous. And as people flooded into the cities in search of work, the problems of crowded housing and poor sanitation increased. Corrupt city leaders called bosses often accepted bribes and gave contracts and jobs to their political allies. The reform movement of progressivism arose to combat the greed, corruption, and other problems that industrialization had created. Progressives, most of whom came from the middle class, wanted to improve the lives of the poor living in America's growing slums. They also condemned the abuses of corporate power and the corruption in city governments. Progressive writers wrote fictional stories and poetry that revealed the hardships faced by many people living in America's cities. Progressive journalists used biting articles and cartoons in newspapers and magazines to expose the corruption of city bosses and business leaders. These writers were called muckrakers because they dug into the dirty deeds of those they wished to expose. Progressives succeeded in creating a public outcry against government corruption. Teddy Roosevelt was America's first progressive president. Between 1901 and 1909, Roosevelt used his position to break up many trusts. These were huge combinations of companies that used their economic power to take advantage of their competitors and workers. Roosevelt's Square Deal was designed to give all Americans, from farmers to businessmen, an equal chance to succeed. Roosevelt created the Pure Food and Drug Act to protect consumers, and he established the National Park System to conserve the environment. Progressives also hoped to win the right for women to vote. Suffragettes, or female activists, had been fighting for the vote since the 1840s. By the early 1900s, support for women's suffrage had grown as more women took jobs and became better educated. Finally, under President Woodrow Wilson, reformers convinced Congress to pass the 19th Amendment to the Constitution. When enough states ratified it, the amendment passed. Now women were guaranteed the right to vote. Despite these improvements, many people felt left behind. America's minority populations and new immigrants continued to face deep prejudices, segregation, and violence. While progressive activists succeeded in reducing corruption, improved worker and food safety, and increased the rights of women, widespread racial injustice and anti-immigrant sentiment remained part of American society.